Good evening, everybody. We start with the webinar. We will not wait for anybody else. People will keep on coming and joining in. Please ensure that your mic is on the mute mode. Now, let's go back to something very basics, which is right in front of our eyes and we don't see it. Now, this is a simple moving average, which will tell you whether this is a bullish pattern or a bearish pattern. Now, we all have seen TradingView. We have been using moving average in and out. But let's be honest, our experience with moving average is just like this. Whenever somebody will ask you to test a moving average, this is the kind of expression you are going to have. Because the pain it has given you is too high. So we will try to filter out the pain. The previous webinar on SMA 21 has been already uploaded on the YouTube and we have tried to modify the way of entry. Now, this is another way of doing it. Moving average ko achhe se samajhna aur use karna bahut zaruri hai, to sideways market mein itna loss deti hai, jitna wo ek baar mein profit nahi deti. To isko zara use karna hum seekhenge aaj. Now, which is the best moving average? If I start asking you, everybody will be just class mein na, primary section mein class mein question puchho na, to everybody gives a different answer. 5, 10, 20, 15, 18, 24, 28, 50, 200, 100. Everybody will give this kind of an answer. Let's be honest. Everybody, I use 20, you use 21, somebody used 24, some use 13, some use 8. So what is actually the way it is? So before I start, there's a standard disclaimer. This is a free education platform. We do not offer any kind of paid courses. Few of the mentors who do take classes, they offer paid courses, but I don't use it. We don't intend to change anybody's investment or trading styles. All presentations under this forum are only for education purposes. None of the mentors in the circle I know are SEBI registered and do not guarantee results in any form. They are basically sharing their experiences with you. Please understand the concept and do ample backtesting and paper trading both before you actually take a trade. Now, what is a moving average? If you put up in the Google, this we have already shown in a previous slide, is a statistic that captures the average change in the data series over the time. So 20 candle agar banengi, to 20 ka average nikaloge, to SMA 20 ban jati. So this is what is a moving average is. So ye formula bahut basic sa formula hai. Wo jaise hum bachcho 10th standard mein mean hi nikalte, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, aisa karke divide by the number of data, that is what is known as the mean. We have a lot of moving averages. We have simple moving averages. We have exponential moving averages. We have double exponential moving averages. So and so and so and so and so and so. I will be trying to teach you only the SMA and you can use EMA also instead of SMA. And I will take on this linear regression. This is only to pick up oversold conditions. And the indicator which I have for it is a really good one, which works for me at least. Now, the simple moving average, which is best used is 21. Now, everybody will say how 21 has come. So 21 is a Fibonacci number. Now, I will prove it again because we see it and we don't use it. This is purely for an intraday purpose only. For positional, we use 50, 100 and 200. So this is the formula for calculating moving average. Don't worry, there will be some theoretical part and then I will be covering the real part of it. Now, if you put commonly used simple moving averages in Google, so this is the answer you are going to get. 10, 20, 50, 100 and 200. These are the answers and you will get how many results? Somewhere maybe, I can't even say the number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe 6, 7 zeros, maybe 8 crore results you may be having on this thing. Now, commonly used simple moving averages. Now, see it. 21 period is the medium term and the most accurate moving average. See it. And good when it comes to riding the trends. while 50 is for the long term and best suited for the long term directions. So I'm talking something which is there on Google, and it's there. You can go and check it for yourself also. The most commonly, the uses of moving averages to identify the trend and to determine support and resistances. Agreed? There's no question about it that we don't use it for these two purposes. This is the main purpose why we use it. We had discussed that retouch technique, a small candle forming on the moving average. So this acts like a support. Lower you put up a stop loss and you take the trade. And is the crossover. So once ever there is a 50 moving average which crossovers 200 moving average, we take the trade. So candles may be somewhere here. So we take the trade. This is the crossover which we normally trade it. So one is to determine support and resistance and crossovers. So today we will discuss both of them in a very nice way. And trust me, you will have not heard of this concept till date. This is something totally different. What is the drawback? It is only useful in trending market. Everybody knows moving average sab ek trending market mein kaam karti hai. Nahi to ye lagging indicator hai, and it generates lot of false signals. So ye baat to almost clear hai ki ye false signals bahut generate karti hai, khaskar sideways market mein jahan pe stop losses bahut hit hote hain. Today we will try to take off these false signals generation in all the forms. Our losses should not be more than the profits we are making. So we'll try to do it. I don't know whether I will be successful or not. So we will try to see it. Now, why we use moving average? We have said the direction of the moving average tells us it is bullish or bearish. Right? Agreed, na? Yehi kehte na ki agar upar ki taraf hai to bullish hai, niche ki taraf hai to bearish hai. तो ये कब जब ऐसे घूमती है तो तब कैसे पता लगेगा कि ये बेरिश हो गई है. ये तो हो सकता है ऐसे घूम के ऐसे हो जाए फिर. सो दिस इज द फॉल्स सिग्नल विच वी आर गोइंग टू फिल्टर आउट टुडे. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस बुलिश और ए बेरिश मूविंग एवरेज. द ओनली वे we know to find out what moving average is going to give us is, or we know how to use a moving average, is direction of the moving average and the crossovers. So we'll use both of them today. Now let's go back to the real basics. This is a bullish candle. We have an opening here and a close here. We are only going to discuss the open and the close. And in a red candle, we have an open on the upper side and close on the lower side. Simple, nothing rocket science. I'm going to keep it on very basic side, on the basic side. In a green candle, we have a close here and an open here. So we have a close here and an open here. Now we'll use these concepts when we go further. Have you ever gone to and see in the moving average, when you put up the moving average chart, in the inputs, there is one is length, time frame, then comes source. We have open, high, low, close, HL2, HL3 and oil. Have you ever tried to use open and close? 99.9% have never even thought about this concept. I had spoken in one of my webinars on it, but how to use it, I will tell you today. So this is how we can use the moving average. And how we use actually moving average, high and low, so it will make a channel. We never make a moving average on these two points. So this is a very small funda. If open is higher than close, then it is a bearish. If close is higher than open, then it is a bullish. Simple funda, which we had seen in the candlesticks. Now let's go and see it, how it works. Now you see this part. If close is higher than open, then we are bullish. If close is below the open, then it's a bearish sign. Right or wrong? I think so. I'm speaking alone. Right? Right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Something new or something old? Okay. I don't know. So close if more than open, then we are bullish. If open is higher than close, greater than close, then we are bearish. Open upar hai, close niche hai, toh hum bearish ho gaye. Hum close upar hai, open niche hai, hum bullish ho gaye. Ab isko hum use karenge. So the tactics to use a moving average crossover has changed, na? Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Let's change the crossover rules also. Na? We will use two moving averages, 21 and a 17. You can use even lesser than that. You can use 8 and 13 also, depending upon your risk appetite and how long trader you are. First EMA, SMA change. That is the shorter one. 17, we will make it green. And second is, the 21, we'll make it red. Simple. So we will trade in direction of green. If green is above the red line, we have a bullish view. If green is below the red, we have a bearish view. I will show you on the trading view chart. But this also doesn't guarantee your sideways market, because sideways it can go like this, and this. Your number of stop losses being hit will decrease, but let's bring it down to real low levels. See, in the stock market, if your stop losses are not being hit, then either you are not trading or you are telling a lie. Is as clear as this possible. If I can tell you, if I say my stop losses don't get hit, then I'm just lying to you. My stop losses get hit, but I am bold enough to accept it. I only try that number of my stop losses being hit should be less. That's why I keep on saying, keep on do a lot of back testing and a paper testing before you actually take a trade. Don't listen to somebody and jump into the trade tomorrow itself. No, don't do it. Please don't do it. It is hard-earned money. Don't waste it like this. Now, ways to tackle the sideways market, we have already discussed in an SMA webinar. That is already there on the YouTube. Anybody wants to listen can go and listen it. But I'm going to use an extra confirmation to trade now. Add RSI period 10. With an upper limit of 60 and a lower limit of 40. And I'm just saying it. Add RSI period 10. That gives you an average of the trading days for the last 10 trading days. And we change the setting of the overbought condition to 60 and the lower limit to 40. Thank you for a patient listening. And let's go to the trading view to see what we have discussed is worth it or not. See, this is what I was already trading today. I was doing a lot of trades on this thing. Now let's go and do on the favorite Reliance chart. Reliance is favorite for everybody. Everybody wants to do it. You can do it on any time frame. Now let's go and put moving average 1, moving average 2. So first is we are going to put up a shorter moving average, that is 17, and we will keep it as close. And we will change the style to green. Just thicken the line. Okay. And now we go and check 21. This is open. We change it to red color. And we see just like this. Now, this crossover. Now, you can't, you should not even put up a stop loss, and you just see how much beautifully you could have ridden it. Almost this is the crossover, and you would have made approximately 2485. And starting from here, somewhere here, you can say 2499, 14 odd rupees, very easily made. So this is a very good way of doing another way of trade. You would have avoided this breakout also because there is no crossover which is happening. So entry here, you can continue remain in the trend till you don't see green over going above it and the candle is below. So your lot of false entries are taken care of by this simple strategy. Simple moving average. I'm not putting anything else. I'm not put up an RSI. I will show you when I put up an RSI. Now you see here. This is a bullish view, but your candles are below it. So you can hold on with your trade. Let it go. Now see what happens. Your trade continues. And the next day morning, it opens up, gaps up. So your whole day, you are riding in one trend. Now see what happens here. The candle goes up, but there is no closure of the candle above the bullish candle moving average. So your trade is avoided and you are still in the sell side and you're holding on to the full day. And your actual trade started somewhere around about here. 2521 to almost this level. It would have got cut at 3 o'clock. So this is the candle, 21 rupees, nearly 1% in Reliance. Now this is what happens in the other stocks. The day you will get a move, like see this move, see how it goes. You are not worried about whatever happens here. All these green candles, you're not worried because the shorter moving averages are always below it. Here you would have exited it. Here, it has a crossover has happened. Now here you would have exited. But this is the whole journey you would have easily enjoyed. Easily enjoyed means easily enjoyed. Anytime it would have come to touch the moving average and a candle closing below it, you would have taken added onto your position and let it ride down. Again, retouch technique. You're working. 1, 2, 3, and it's over. 1 touch, 2 touch, 3 touch, and the fourth, you are almost exiting it. Now, this is why I was saying Bharti Airtel may be on the bullish side on Monday. Kalesa, please switch off your camera. You are taking my bandwidth. We don't want to see you. So, Kalesa, I think so. I fail to understand what you want. Now, this is where I am thinking this will go on the bullish side. See, if you increase the time frame to 30 minutes, it becomes a positional trade. No? You see here, enter here, you exit here. So you can do the increase. Once you start increasing the time frame, you become you will be riding big waves. So you can do it. Actually, you need to understand the concept. If the open is below the close, that means it's a green candles. For the last 17 candles, the close has been higher than the 21 average of the moving, the open. So that itself signifies there is a slight change in the trend. You can make it 21-21 also. There's no harm in it. But the lines become too close to each other. They will keep on doing all hanky-panky stuff. You will get a little panicky on it always. So increase the close, just try to decrease it by this thing so that you see a difference also between it. Now, how to filter out false signals? So we were supposed to add RSI, simple RSI, which is there in the default, all free indicators. 10. We don't need a middle band, we need a lower band. Now you trade only when the RSI is above 60. Your entry is not here. It will almost signify at the same level where the crossover will happen, or little one or two candles late, or maybe one or two candles there. And you exit the moment there is a candle in the RSI which is below 60. So this candle you exit. You exit. And see, from there the market started falling down. So you are not losing money, you are at least making money. You do not enter a sell trade till you don't have an RSI also going below 40. So in the sideways zone, we are going to avoid the market and we short the share out here. The green line is below the red line and we let the trade run. Moment there is a closure of the candle above it, we exit the trade. That is here. We exit the trade. So this is how you filter out the false signals. Let me see where the false signal. Now you had here the candles going above the both moving averages. So it's in a sideways zone. The market has gone into the sideways zone. It came down, and suddenly it's on the close of the day. It just closed at the end. Next day morning, it opened up with an RSI above almost 60. So you can keep on riding the waves like this going down. Now you see here again, this is the crossover happening. You had again going here. Now let's pick up some other stock like Bank Nifty. Let's pick up Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty gives a beautiful return. See here the crossover. You have an RSI going below it. And now you keep on riding it till you don't see an R wave come, a candle closing over. Exit it. Don't get greedy that you are going to do everything. Now change over. This is the crossover. This is your candle. Your candle closed below it, exit. Another candle closes above it. Okay, fine. We get back into the trade. And here we exit the trade. If we do not try exit the trade, we may end up having a stop loss hit. Now you see, you could have easily gone up till here also. But this RSI, this is going up and up again and again. We don't know which way the next candle is going to form. So we have to only ride the wave. Now you had this candle coming down. Now you see here how your false entry is stopped. You had an RSI under 40, but there a crossover has not happened. It is a bullish. So the conditions are not met. The conditions are met on this candle. But your very next candle, it went up and closed here. A Mura trading wali hai. Exit the trade immediately. Exit the trade. Loss le lenge koi baat nahi. Par kitna ek candle se chota hi ka hai na. Not even the low of the candle has been touched. So this is the whole concept of being it. So any questions, anybody? Now it's a very simple thing which I have tried to. Now you see here, no crossovers. RSI above it. We are not taking a trade. We'll wait till it doesn't give it. It's a red candle. So we are not taking on this thing. We'll wait for this green candle. Green candle, we had almost a sideways market out here. Just over it. The very next candle, we could have, it is coming and touching it. And we are exiting out here. And we had entered here. So we don't know where the market is going. This is showing a bullish way, but it turned the other way. So moving average is a lagging indicator. We are just filtering out our false signals out here. So any more questions now, anybody? And see the kind of rides you are going to make here. Nifty, you would have made a ride up till this point. Yes, sir. Anybody? No questions. I'm done almost.
Sir,
hello. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. So it is RSI above 60, you are buying, and then RSI goes below 60, you are selling. Am I clear on this, sir?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Okay. So then how are you interpreting the below 40 RSI signal? Just can you explain again?
Below, ma'am, here is this is first is look at this part. Green has come below the red. So we are trading in the line where the color green is. Now see where the RSI turns under 30, under 40, and it's a red candle we are getting. This is the candle, ma'am, we get.
Okay.
Yeah, and we then ride the wave till we don't have an RSI candle closing or there we see a crossover coming. Most likely the RSI will give you always the first exit signal. This is why I have kept it a filtering out. We at least make all most of our profits. We don't end up giving our profits to anybody else. So this is the most important. Your candle on which you are going to take a trade has to be green. Don't try to take it on a red candle because it may be coming down like this. So don't try to do it. So only always
see. Does this work in larger time frames as well or 30 minutes?
I'm seeing on 30 minutes. Oh. I'm seeing on 30 minutes. You can do it like this. But on a daily time, 1 hourly time frame, then the settings have to be very less. It should be 8 and 13 max. It should not be such a high time frame because your maximum move will be already done by the time you take the trade. You see, na, here the you are getting signal out here and then it comes back here.
Thank you.
It is like
that. Thanks.
Okay. So we have second class also after this, which we will not be doing recording. Strike prices, please. This is only not for options in any form. I tried doing an option, but the wicks are so big that it will come and hit your stop loss immediately. So I tried to do it in options, but you see here, the kind of rides it's going to give you is a retouch, sir. Dhyan se dekho, this is a retouch technique. It is coming and touching it. Small candle and you ride the wave. I normally pick up, I've been always saying you pick up the small candles. Look for small candles because your stop losses are going to be very less. Because if you pick big candles like this, you can go, like you pick like this, suddenly your stop loss, see it went up, and but still it was a bearish. You see this, the bearish view persists on this thing. It may come down and hit you badly. You are saved here. No? You see, if you would have taken even here on such a big and this candle came and closed up above it, what you would have just paid a couple of rupees out of your pocket. Because the exit has been almost at the same price where you had entered. So this is the most important part. The exit has to be on the very, if the stop loss are going to get hit, then it is. Now you see what happened here. Your green is below the red. So you're not taking a bullish stance because it turned like this again. And this sideways market saved you from taking a buy trade also. So any more questions, sir? I'm just trying to show you a few examples.
So sir, ideal stop loss kis rakhne?
Ma'am, stop loss rakhne ki zarurat kya? RSI aapko bata raha hai na.
Okay, sir.
RSI bata raha hai aapko. Aapko ghoom ke RSI. Ab you never know RSI ab yahan pe rehta hai, yahan jata hai ki wapas ekdam ghoom jata hai. Ab ye dekho yahan hua. Dekho kaise ghooma. Here it entered and if you had exited on the RSI, now let's say we have to exit.
Disturbance, sir.
Ye Sujit kya se ho raha?
Sir, logo pata nahi. Chalo. अब आप इसको देखें बड़े ध्यान से, ये वाला पार्ट देखें. आपकी एंट्री इस कैंडल पे हुई, क्रॉसओवर है, आपकी कंडीशन मैच हो रही है, एकदम आरएसआई अंदर घुस गया यहाँ पे, तो आपने मैक्सिमम अपने कैंडल से थोड़ा सा नीचे ही लॉस खाया ना. अगर आप इसको बैठे रहते बाय में, आपको तो पूरा उस दिन उसने पूरा खाली करके चले जाना था. हमारा एग्जिट मैडम, हमने लालच नहीं करनी. अगर ट्रेड हमारे अगेंस्ट आ रहा है, हम जल्दी लॉस काट के चले जाएं. बट जिस दिन हम ये वाला दिन मिले, ऐसा दिन मिले, हम उस दिन बाहर ना निकले. अब आप देखो, बैठे रहो सारा दिन ट्रेड में, आप यहाँ पहली बार निकल रहे होते, अभी भी आपका वो नीचे है कैंडल. वी डोंट नो ये कैंडल ऊपर जाती नीचे जाएगी नेक्स्ट कैंडल ना. नेक्स्ट देखो खुली, नेक्स्ट ऊपर इतनी ऊपर है, गैप अप खुली फिर नीचे आ गई. आपका तो बेयरिश व्यू परसिस्ट कर रहे हैं ना. तो जैसी कैंडल यहाँ पे क्लोज होती, आपने इसको स्टॉप लॉस बना के आप नीचे ट्रेड कर लो पूरा बैठ के सर. यहाँ
थैंक यू सर.
गुड इवनिंग सर.
गुड इवनिंग जी.
सर आपका जो 21 रीटच वाला जो है दैट वन आई एम वर्किंग, तो उसमें इसका कुछ एडिशन में क्या करूँ सर, वो आपका सजेशन चाहिए था.
ये देखिए सर, ये देखिए, बड़ा ध्यान से देखें. ये रीटच है, रीटच में हम 17 यूज नहीं करते हैं, ठीक है,
बराबर 21 नहीं करते,
ये 21 यूज किया,
यस सर,
आपका आरएसआई कहाँ है,
नहीं, हाँ बराबर,
ठीक है, बच गया ना फॉल्स एंट्री से,
यस सर, डन सर,
डन, अब आपका नीचे जाके ग्रीन कैंडल बन के अगर कटा तो आपने ट्रेड ले लेना है, तो आपके इस कैंडल पर ट्रेड बना, नीचे आरएसआई देखो कहाँ है, अब ट्रेड देखो कहाँ तक जा रहा है आपका,
चालू है,
चालू है, ये रीटच आ गया आपका फिर दोबारा, ये आपका नहीं आ रहा सही है, छोड़ दो इसको ट्रेड को, क्योंकि वहां से मार्केट वापस घूमी है, देखो नीचे थोड़ी आए फिर घूमी मार्केट,
पर सर 21 में मैं क्लोज कर रहा हूँ, क्लोज वाली देख रहा हूँ,
आप तो देख लो सर, एक समय को मैं चेंज कर देता हूँ सर, इसमें क्या बात है,
नहीं सर आई एम जस्ट,
उसमें कितना फर्क पड़ जाएगा,
बराबर सर, और सर 5 मिनट चलेगा ना इसमें,
आप 5 मिनट ले लो सर, मैं तो पांच, मैं तो बहुत ही कम, मैं तो बड़ा अजीब अजीब टाइम फ्रेम पे करता हूँ सर, ये देखो अब देखो आपकी दो कैंडल बनी, इसका नीचे जोन सी कैंडल कट हुई, क्या बना आपका आरएसआई, यहाँ पे है, बैठे रहो ट्रेंड में, कब तक है, यहाँ निकलोगे, इस डोजी पे निकल गए, मार्केट ऊपर भी गई, आपको पैनिक तो हुआ नहीं ना कोई भी,
नहीं नहीं नहीं,
अब बैठे रहो, अब इसके ऊपर गई है, आपका एक छोटा सा स्टॉप लॉस सेट हुआ होगा, आपका ये ट्रेड तो आपको पूरे पैसे दे गया ना,
बराबर,
ये गया, ये देखो आपकी इस कैंडल पे हुआ स्टिमुलेट, इस पे आपका खत्म हो गया, आप कॉस्ट टू कॉस्ट या थोड़ा सा प्रॉफिट बना के बाहर निकलोगे,
बराबर,
सो यू नीड टू फिल्टर आउट द योर एंट्रीज, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर मार्केट को देना हमने 100 रुपए है, पर लेना 1000 रुपए है मार्केट से,
ये ज्यादा फिल्ट्रेशन मिल जाएगा,
ये तो बहुत ज्यादा फिल्ट्रेशन है सर, अभी इसके बाद आपको वो कराऊंगा जिसमें एक लाइन के ऊपर ही काम चलता है सर,
क्या बात,
वो तो वो एक लाइन पे ही काम चलता है, बस एक लाइन होगी, बस उसी लाइन पे काम चलेगा,
बढ़िया सर, थैंक यू,
सो एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस, क्योंकि फिर पवन सर भी आगे होंगे, फिर मैं उनको देना,
हाँ सर सुजीत बोल रहा हूँ,
हाँ सुजीत बताएं,
हाँ सर ये सही है तरीका, मीन्स आरएसआई का बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे, एक बहुत बता दीजिए सर, ये इंट्राडे में 3 मिनट्स का यूज करना है, 5 मिनट्स के 15 मिनट्स का यूज करना है
सर, आप ये लो सर, ये लो 3 मिनट्स पे कर लो, जितना शॉर्टर टाइम फ्रेम उतना नॉइस आपको मिलेगा, ये देखो अब 3 मिनट्स में आपने किया ना, तो आपका ये क्रॉसओवर हुआ, ठीक है, ये रेड कैंडल है, आपने यहाँ पे ट्रेड नहीं लिया, छोड़ दिया, आपको जो सा टाइम फ्रेम बोल रहा हूँ मैं उस पे दिखा रहा हूँ, नीचे आया आपका यहाँ बना, पर यहाँ पे आपका आरएसआई ऊपर है, डोंट टेक ए ट्रेड, नो ट्रेड्स आर टेकन, आप देखो जब आपका बाय बना यहाँ पे, ये देखो ये आपकी नेक्स्ट कैंडल बाय बना, जैसी अंदर घुसी कैंडल आपने यहाँ पे एग्जिट कर जाना था, अब आपके 3 मिनट के अकॉर्डिंग तो बैंक निफ्टी या बियरिश में आ रही है, बट वी विल वेट टिल हियर, वी विल वेट टिल हियर, सो 5 मिनट्स इज आई थिंक सो गुड टाइम टू डू इट, नियरली 5 मिनट्स में, देखो सर देखिए 5 मिनट्स में देखो ये 60 के पास है, ये देखो कैंडल ये रीटच कर रही है, अगर ये कैंडल एक कल एक ग्रीन ऊपर हल्के से बंद हुई तो बैंक निफ्टी बुलिश में रहेगी मेरे लिए, मैं बियरिश में नहीं हूँ निफ्टी में किसी भी फॉर्म में,
नहीं वही पर्टिकुलरली इंट्राडे में 5 मिनट और 15 मिनट में देखते, बट कभी कभी एग्जिट पोजीशन आती है तो 3 मिनट में जाके देखने भी सही रहेगा, क्वेश्चन वही था मेरा एक्चुअली
सर, अभी आप ये देखो इससे तगड़ा क्या बताऊं आपको, अल्ट्राटेक में 7849 5 रुपए का स्टॉप लॉस,
राइट राइट,
कहाँ गई आपकी मार्केट, आपको 5 रुपए के बदले में अगर हाईएस्ट पॉइंट आप, मैं मान के चलूंगा, मैं मानता हूँ आप आधे में निकल गए यहाँ पे भी, तो 50 रुपए तो फिर बना के निकलोगे ना
आराम से,
तो रीटच को इसको किसी भी टेक्निक के साथ अगर आप मैच कर गए तो याद रखना आपको पैसा सबसे ज्यादा उसमें आएगा, सबसे ज्यादा पैसा रीटच में आता है, ये बात
इंपॉर्टेंट,
हाँ रीटच में बहुत पैसा आता है, मैं तो बहुत करता हूँ रीटच, मैं तो आज भी अगर मुझे मौका मिले मैं सबसे पहले रीटच करूंगा, मैं किसी ना किसी एक वे से कंफर्म करता हूँ उसको, आई नीड वन कंफर्मेशन, मैं तो बहुत सिंपल एक बात बताऊँ, 1:1 पे तो पहले ही वैसे अपना आधी क्वांटिटी बुक कर लो, सो दैट प्रॉफिट इज ऑलवेज इन योर हैंड,
राइट सर,
1:1 पे तो बुक कर लो, कि आपने सोचा मैंने 10 रुपए बुक करने, बुक कर लो, एटलीस्ट घर पैसा तो आ रहा है ना
बराबर, कैपिटल भी थोड़ा तो बच गया
बच गया ना, ठीक है,
थैंक यू सर,
एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस एनीबडी हैज, पवन सर आ गए क्लास में,
यस सर, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग पवन सर। पवन सर, कल आपकी बड़ी डिमांड आई थी, मैं एक्शन रिकॉर्डिंग स्टॉप करता हूं जरा, एक्शन फॉर एवरीबॉडी।
तो पर्टिकुलरली ऑप्शन में यूज नहीं हो सकता है ना, निफ्टी बैंक निफ्टी ऑप्शन
सर? ऑप्शन में विक्स पता है कितनी बड़ी बड़ी बनती, इतनी बड़ी बड़ी विक्स बनती
है, वही प्रॉब्लम है। यस यस यस,
ऑप्शंस के लिए ना मैंने एक अलग से कोई चीज कर रहा हूँ, पर वो कंसिस्टेंटली नहीं चलती है सर। मतलब ये 70% आपको फिर बेनिफिट दे जाएगा, ऑप्शंस में नहीं देता। हाँ, इसमें एक तरीका और है मार्जिन कम करने के लिए, वो ये है यू बाय द फ्यूचर एंड सेल ए लोअर पुट, तो आपको पुट का डिके मिल जाता है और फ्यूचर में अगर वो थोड़ा भी मूवमेंट 8-10 रुपए का ऊपर मूवमेंट करता है तो आपको दोनों तरफ से पैसा मिल जाता है। अच्छा, मार्जिन पर रिक्वायरमेंट इज नंबर 2 लाख रुपीज। I have to still to try it. I will try it sooner or later. मैं तो अभी आजकल पवन सर के साथ एक बड़ी different technique कर रहा हूँ, मैं आपको दिखा देता हूँ। I'm working on it very day and night on it. I don't use any indicator, so I remove it. Remove indicators. मैंने किस पे करा था अभी? ये देखो। I'm working. मैं पवन सर के साथ ये थोड़ा सा इसको devise कर रहा हूँ तरीके को. How to trade it? 1, 2, 3. Third trade मेरा चल रहा है. Third trade चल रहा है मेरा आज दिन का. मेरे 2 profit में कम हुए and I'm just holding on with my third trade. And मेरा अभी तक वो मतलब कि stop losses मैंने बहुत कम रखे हुए हैं इस बार में. ये बहुत ये लाइनें हैं मेरा stop loss सारी. पवन सर, I'm stopping the recording.